Sir, how do you think that tech innovations is going to change the automobile and automotive industry?
You see, we are at the moment at the threshold of a very major development, okay. Very major growth in the country. No doubt, today the automotive sector, we are looking to going through a phase of recession. But that's temporary, cyclical. But in the long term, the philosophy and the environment that we have in the country is phenomenal growth available. By 2030, we are looking at a total market of about 10 million passenger car vehicles, which is today only at about 4 million passenger car vehicles, which has taken probably right from 47 to now, almost 75 years to really come to that level.
Right.
And today, in 10 years, we are going to be growing by 250%. So the kind of technology, kind of innovations, the kind of growth that is needed is phenomenal. Well, technology is available in the world. We have just to get it. And finance, yes, we need to organize that. And so that the adequate amount of funds are available to fund that growth. Because the growth is not going to happen just without what we already have as accruals. Because accruals are not sufficient to fund the 250% growth.
Right.
So there has to be infusion. There has to be psychological factors for people who are first-time entrepreneurs, owners, 100% owners of companies to dilute. Share, expand. That's the motto. And that is how that will carry us forward.
Okay. So what do you think that how startups and SMEs and small traders, what role they are going to play in this big mark, achieving this big mark and
you
dream
see,
come true?
Everybody in the global space has a place of its own. Like in OEM market, there are tier one, the original manufacturers, then there are supplemented by tier twos, tier threes. There's a whole lot of supply chain, which is managed by different levels of people. So even the startups, if in the automotive or the manufacturing industry will be different from the startups, which are talking in terms of technological industries or information technology, that is different. There, that is a kind of disruptive technology somebody might come out with. Somebody might fail. I mean, if there are 100 startups, there might be cases of about 10 or 15% successes. No doubt. But then, are those people who are not successful in the first attempt, are they giving up? No, they should not. Okay. But probably, it's very easy to say for me. Again, it depends on the individual factors of the person who is in that frame.
Okay.
So, what is needed is a will to do it, like you say, a fire to dream.
Yeah.
You have to live that dream. If you have to live that dream, you got to have that fire to move towards that.
What do you think about the electric mobility space and how it is going to change the scenario of India in the automotive sector?
A very large portion of focus is attached to the electric mobility. No doubt electric mobility is the future, but are we going to go away from the industrial internal combustion engines? No,
okay.
Certainly not. The only question is, right now we are focusing on electric mobility because that is what is needed. It will only at best generate maybe about 10% of the total market demand, or by 2030 it might be about 1 million every year, which is about 10%. So 1 million also starting from very, very minuscule levels today is a huge growth.
Right.
So that will be a much bigger growth. Yes, that's the reason why it is talked about. It's offering a lot of opportunity for new horizons.
Right.
And well, with this is the infrastructure that is needed. But before we move on to the electric mobility, we already have a pollution-free industry like LPG, compressed natural gas, CNG.
Yeah.
Well, for CNG itself, we still do not have enough infrastructure in place to feed the market. Today, as you go across, it is not available out of the major cities. And even in the major cities, there are long queues. So what does it mean? We need more facilities for CNGs. CNG is by no means a technology which is polluting.
Right.
It is maybe the focus on that in creating that infrastructure has somewhere got lost.
You mean to say that more infrastructure and more facilities are required?
Definitely. It will maybe achieve the same amount of goals in containing the pollution. I'm not saying that electric mobility will not do that for us. It will do. But the question is that will take a longer time. This is what will give you the immediate benefits. Today, we are suffering because of lack of the facilities. Maybe that also might mean a lower amount of capital investment from the government sector to create that kind of infrastructure to generate the facilities that are needed. I don't know, I can't comment on that. I'm not an expert on that, but I do feel that's something already tried and tested. Let us keep on focusing while not losing the major focus on the electric mobility.
First create a proper infra for CNG, then move on to mobility.
It has to move on parallelly. Of course, have a focus and priority on CNG, because that is what is already available. That is what will deliver you the immediate benefits. That is the future. So move on. The future must go on parallelly with the current situation.
Ultimately, a balance will be achieved.
Yes, that's what I think.
Thank you, sir. Thank you for talking to Zee.
Thank you
for your inputs.
Thank you.